Hi guys, welcome to the Live the Life You Love podcast. I'm your host, Joshua, and this time, in episode number 10, it's about an important theme. It's about how you can be free from the power fields of darkness that we talked about in episode number 9. So, all credits go to www.puramaryam.de. Thank you for your great work, dear Maryam. And we get started. Lean back and enjoy. Freeing yourself from the power fields of darkness. You can do energy work on yourself to dissolve certain habits, patterns of behavior, certain reactions, patterns of addiction, aging, impaired eyesight, impaired hearing, compulsive acts, problems with others, low self-esteem, and many more, and you will have a wonderful success doing so. But only when dissolving the relating formative power fields in your aura, you will be able to rid yourself from these problems for good. But power fields are not only to be found in the aura of humans and animals, but also in apartments, shops, locations, villages, cities, landscapes, states, continents, and Earth itself. You can learn here how to dissolve those power fields. At first, I suggest that you read all the pages to the subject, unconditional love, because all of them are very important to learn to know what love is. Learn from the instructions you find there to feel love and to work with love. And also, all the pages to the subject energetic clearing with the given instructions are very helpful. Take the time you need for learning all about energy work, even if you have a lot of pressure from your problems. It is better to start out calmly and thoroughly with a profound knowledge than to hurry through the process. Because knowledge and attentive accuracy are basic for your success and help you to avoid any dangers. Before the treatment, I advise you ask the angels for a light cone for as long as you think it is necessary. And then pray to God, asking for His help, His grace, and His protection. For the treatment, we lay our hands upon our heart chakra, or we hold the hands within our aura, with the inside of our hands put together, like the Catholics pray. When laying our hands upon another person, we may hold them upon the crown chakra, or we hold them in this person's aura with the insides of our hands put together. It is much better, though, to show that person how to do it himself, so he can help himself. Now we ask God, Father, Mother, for His light and His love for us. Then we go into unconditional love with the highest intensity possible, while staying completely relaxed. During the whole treatment, we should keep our minds on the power fields for a certain subject, or we keep our minds on the power fields connected with a certain subject. Be assured that during the whole treatment, God is there to help you. He is the healer, not us. So afterwards, you should thank him as well as the angels. After having learned the easy practice, everyone is able to work with love at once. At first for your own good, then also as a help for others. Maybe you will feel some pressure sometimes, the prick of needles, some pain or a prickle. That are the energies that are leaving you. At first, you may not feel very much, so just keep on working patiently, fully trusting that your work is effective. The energies that are dissolving are leaving you over your foot chakras, so your feet may feel cool or even cold. To avoid falling back into your old customary ways after all, you should also direct your consciousness onto the energies in your aura and in your chakras that are connected with this certain problem. Do not forget that your brain has kept the memory of the problem and clear the energy stored there with love as well. And at last, you should also clear the energies connected with this problem stored in your body cells, because those have consciousness too, and store memories as well. Repeat this work every day until you feel really free from your problem. To make sure it is totally gone, though, you may love your former problem again sometime later. Be sure that this work is very effective. In the course of it, you will be changing by and by, and your abilities will increase. You may realize that your ability to love more intensely every day will initiate a wonderful process of inner learning and advancement. And maybe you will feel from time to time that this process seems to have come to a standstill. But this is not so, because in those time of apparent stagnation, the most important processes may happen without your knowing it. So give yourself all the time, you, your body, your mind, and your soul need. Enjoy this important time of your life, which may well be the most beautiful and fulfilling time you had so far. Enjoy and treasure every sign of success, how small it may be, because it carries you forward step by step. Be sure that everything you are learning is your innermost treasure that nobody can take away from you. You will profit from your knowledge even in your further future incarnations. Nothing, and I mean nothing at all, is in vain. When doing this kind of light work, you will always be guided and protected, as you have the loving help of our brothers and sisters of light. By working at those fields in our aura, we may stop behavioral disorders and certain thought patterns that could cause disease. We also may stop patterns of addiction and the thought patterns connected with addiction. We may dissolve unsocial and criminal tendencies, heal depression, rid ourselves from karma, free ourselves from aging the way we used to know it. We may help our children to find an easier way to life. Only the little children, the older ones, have to agree, but we show them to do this work themselves so they can become self-responsible. We may rid ourselves from hindering patterns, free our pets from conditioning that is impairing their joy in life. We may make places, sites, and cities much nicer for people to live in. We may enhance the atmosphere of apartments and houses noticeably. And we may take away the atmosphere of fear and need from shops and business sites in case another business had to close down there previously. We may free Mother Earth from her troubles and much more. Please keep this carefully in mind. We are only allowed to work for ourselves, for animals or plants, for cities, countries and earth without limitation. Other people have to ask us for this help. The same goes for family members and our older children, who already have an own free will. We can treat our own small children, though, without them having to ask us. Before treating other children, their parents have to agree, respectively, the children themselves, depending on their age. If possible, you should also ask for their soul's consent. It is the principle that everybody should help himself so he may learn and grow this way. Namely, it is important to respect that each human being learns from his own problems, his karma for inner growth, and he grows by realizing what he is lacking, what he has done wrong in order to feel these consequences. When we relieve somebody of a problem unasked, we take away his chance to grow by it. This again creates karma for us, because we prevent the other person's growth. We should not help others because we just want to do so, because we still have so much pity for them. That would be manipulation. Pity is no help, but an obstacle. Go into your heart's compassion instead, a quality of unconditional love, and you will realize what your desire to help actually is. It just serves you, your own ego, by making you feel to be a helper. We can only help others if we have the consent of that soul which we can presuppose when they personally request our help. We do not need the person's consent though when we send love over a distance, because in that case, the soul can decide for itself whether or not it wants to accept our love. In case of doubt, I always say, "Dear God, your will shall be done, not mine, but yours, and the will of the soul." We can do this work only in spiritual consciousness and in accordance with God. That is why it is important to pray. Furthermore, we cannot give this help for commercial purpose. So guys, you heard it. Learn the unconditional love on www.puramariam.de or on my YouTube channel Yoshuabenchristus to get rid of the formative fields of darkness. I wish you much success with your light work. Feel embraced. Have a nice morning, a nice day, or a nice night. Wherever you are, kisses, bye bye, and ciao ciao, your Yoshua.